Okay, hi you guys. I'm here with my very first makeup tutorial. This makeup tutorial is going to be my everyday look. I've mentioned this in a lot of my videos, but I'm very, very new to makeup. I just started doing it last year. And this is the everyday look that I've come up with doing a lot of research on YouTube and just seeing like different techniques. This is the technique that I have found that works best for me and my skin type. I do have oily skin and very oily eyelids. So stay tuned if you're interested in seeing how I get my very natural everyday look. Also too, the light you see coming in is all natural lighting. So what you see on camera is what you'll see when I go outside. So the very first thing that I do is I moisturize my face with aloe vera gel, and I just take a little bit on my finger and I dab it like this, and then I rub it all in. Oh, I have a camera down. I mean, not a camera, but I have a mirror down here. So that's why you'll see me looking down a lot. All right. Also make sure I get my eyelids too, because they need moisture as well. All right. Huh. That's my face. That's it. That's the moisture that I put on. And what I'll do is I just kind of let the moisture soak into the skin. And as I'm doing that, I get ready. So I mentioned earlier, I have a lot of dry skin. So the first thing that I do is actually, I put on a mattifying face powder. So I have like this cute little retractable travel brush, which I really like, nice and fluffy, and then you can put the top on. But I use a mattifying face powder. Now I am in Moldova, so I don't have access to like translucent setting powders and things like that. So I actually use cornstarch. So I take a little bit of cornstarch on this brush and I just kind of like dab it all over my face. All right, and then I push it down to kind of make the brush more fluffy, and then I blend all of that in. Also making sure to get over my eyelids because they are oily too. And this is just to kind of help reduce some of the oil that'll be seeping through my skin later today. All right, so I think at this point, I feel like when I look in the mirror, I look a little refreshed already. And so the next thing I do is one extra measure I have to make sure I don't get oily as well is I use this, this mattifying beauty base. I've mentioned this in a couple of my videos, and I only apply this to my really, really oily areas. So I take about this much on my hand, and I pat it into my oily areas, and I pat it in so that I kind of fill my pores and make sure that it gets like really, really matte. And same thing on the other side. I have this zit here today, so let's see if the makeup will do a good job of covering that up. Sorry, I'm looking down. Once again, my mirror's down here. And then I always make sure I get my forehead, because my forehead is something serious. I normally get oily around my forehead, my nose, pretty much the T-zone here and here. And then I'll take a little bit and I'll put it on my nose. And like I said, I'm patting it in because it seems to stay matte longer when I pat it in as opposed to just wiping it over. And then I also put some right here because of my smile lines. And I try to add some here so that like it can fill the line in, so that when I go throughout the day, like it's not as noticeable. And then after I've patted it in, then I'll slowly rub it in. And I really like this base because it's really smooth, soft, and silky, like makes my skin feel silky smooth. I really like it. All right, so that's that. Oh, and I also put some on my eyelids too. I forgot about my eyelids. Put some on my eyelids so that they can stay matte throughout the day as well, because I have really oily eyelids. All right, so yeah, that's how I do that. Okay. Okay, next what I do is I go in with my foundation. So I actually carry my foundation around in this contact lens case. I saw this on another video, and it's a really good way to travel with your makeup to have just enough. So on this side I have my liquid foundation, on this side I have powder foundation. So I get my makeup and I'll grab a little bit and just kind of dab it all over my face. All right, so I think that's enough. And as much as I can. Okay, so that's that. And then what I do is I take my beauty blender. My beauty blender, it's been sitting in this bowl of water for a while. And so I'll squeeze out my beauty blender. And if you saw my last eBay haul, this is the beauty blender that I got. And I said if you let it soak in water, it gets like really nice and soft. So it's really nice and soft and ready to be used. So actually what I'm gonna do is take a mirror and kind of see if I can blend everything in. So yeah, I just take my beauty blender. It's dirty because I've used it already like yesterday. So all right, and then I just start blending everything in. I really love putting on makeup with this beauty blender because it blends everything flawlessly. So I'm gonna do half my face so you can see how the foundation looked. With just half, and always make sure I try to blend in at the hairline and come down the neck just a tidbit. Mm-hmm. So I'm just trying to do half right now. Love the beauty blender. And then again at the hairline, just kind of I roll the beauty blender at the hairline to just kind of make it seamlessly blend in. All right, so this is how half of my face looks with makeup. Nose isn't all the way blended. So this is how half, so this half has it all blended out, and then this side still has to be blended. So you can kind of see already that it just makes my skin look very even and flawless. And I have some discoloration around here. It doesn't completely eliminate it, but it makes it less noticeable, which I'm okay with. When I do makeup, I don't need to look 100% flawless. I just like to, for it to look natural and for it to look really nicely blended. All right, so I'm gonna continue blending. Sorry. Once again, try to bring it down the neck a little bit and then roll it once you get by the ear. And again, roll it once you get by the hairline. Just to kind of blend it all out and make it look like your skin. So. So that's how I apply my foundation, and then always after I'm done, I do a scan over on my face to see if there's any areas that need a little touching up. This area doesn't look like it's all the way blended, so I'm gonna tap the beauty blender some more and blend a little bit. Oh, thanks for my camera. And you can see this is it. It's not completely covered, but it doesn't look as red as it did originally. My eyelids, make sure those are still covered. And then, so from looking at it, I feel like the forehead and everything is blended out pretty nicely, but I feel like in this area it could use just a little bit more, so I'm gonna apply just a little bit more foundation there. Just kind of cover those dark spots. And then blend it out just a tidbit more. All Okay. I feel like that looks good. Alright, so that's my foundation. And then after I do my foundation, then that's when I go in and I set my foundation. And I normally set my foundation with the same translucent setting powder that I use, aka cornstarch. And that's just to set the foundation. I could use another foundation that I have, but I find that when I put the other foundations on top of it, I notice that I tend to get more oily and my face looks more cakey. So I actually like to just set it with the translucent setting powder to just give a very nice, natural, soft look to my face. So that's just so there's not like too much going on or whatever. All right, so that's my foundation. And I'm gonna come back and show you guys how I do my eyeshadow and the rest of my face. Stay tuned. Okay, so now it's time to do eyeshadow. So I'm gonna give you guys a little secret. I actually don't, so my current everyday eyeshadow look, I have not been using actual eyeshadow. I've been using blush. And to be honest with you, all the products that we have, we can use it as we see fit. I found that this color, it really is a very natural looking color on me. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my eyeshadow. I've pretty much already primed and prepped my eyes or whatever with the foundation and the mattifying base. So what I do is I just kind of gently tap it on. Now, I used to do a crease color back when I first got into makeup because that's like the official thing to do. But lately, I haven't been doing crease colors, and I'm not sure why. But I've kind of been liking, I feel like it kind of looks a little more natural without the crease color. So I haven't really been doing the crease color so much, you know? I guess I can make this like a chit chat video. I've seen that a couple of times. So over the weekend, I went to a yoga retreat. I also do yoga. And it was very, very inspiring. I did a lot of yoga last year in the winter time here. And for some reason this winter, I just couldn't seem to get out of bed and get on my mat. And so a couple of other Peace Corps volunteers are trying to implement some yoga programs in their village. And I have a pretty successful Zumba program in my village or whatever. And so they wanted me to come and share my insight and see how I can help them with getting something started in their village. And it was really nice. Like, we shared a lot of like yoga practices, and we did a lot of meditation, and it was just really awesome to have a weekend just full of yoga, where you just meditate and practice yoga and just talk and be open and free. And just, it was a really cool weekend. And then the host that I stayed with, they're vegan, and so it was really nice to be eating nice, clean food, and it was just a really good weekend. And so, honestly, ever since I've been back, I've been, and I'm going to use a blending brush. I didn't even show you this brush. This is just a eyeshadow brush where you just pack on eyeshadow to blend out the crease. And so, yeah, like, it was just really nice to be able to kind of like relax, get away from sight, and see what other volunteers are doing and share my insight. And yeah, it was just a really good weekend overall. So yeah. All right. And so I feel like I messed up my eyeshadow just a little bit. So normally I have to go back in and like fix certain areas. Like, this isn't, I mean, it's not eyeshadow, so it's not gonna, I don't think it's gonna be as pigmented. It takes a little bit to build up, I'll just say that, because it's not eyeshadow, so. And it's also not that great quality, but it works for what I got. Alright. So that's that. I think I'm satisfied with it. I'm gonna actually look up so I can just barely get the edge. Let's just kind of like blend it out. Alright, so that's all blended. Next what I do is I go in with my eyeliner. I had been using a liquid eyeliner with like a little brush for a while, but I recently ordered this off of eBay. Spoiler alert, this is going to be in my next eBay haul. And I like to show you guys I actually use my products before I do the hauls. So this is how the pan looks, and I really like it. It says that it's waterproof. I don't know how true that is, but actually I'm gonna do that with this, but I don't know how true it being waterproof is, but it definitely makes applying eyeliner a whole lot easier. And so I start from the inside of my eye. I hope you guys can see. So from the inside of my eye, and then I'll just draw a line, right? And I'll just fill in the area underneath the line. Normally take my time with it. And this pen is really awesome with, like, say that you want to do like a wing liner. Like, this pen is just great for that. And yeah, when I first used it, I didn't really like it that much, but it's really growing on me. It's very travel friendly, and yeah, I like it a lot. Alright, so that's that. I'm gonna do the other side. So later today I have English lessons with this really smart, beautiful high school student who's been learning English with me since I've been here. Really sweet girl. So, yeah, once again, just draw the line and then fill it in. I can't really see if I'm filling it in or not. I want to get the middle a little bit more. Okay, that's good. I'm going to go over my line one more time, make sure it's nice and straight and thick. Alright, yeah. So, that's my eyeliner. I'll tell you, this pencil has been a lifesaver. So, I really like that. And then, normally what I do is I'll go in and do my mascara. Hold on just a sec. Okay, yeah. So, I think we got time to do mascara. I'm going to use this mascara. It's the Maybelline Colossal Volume Express. It's a European brand, so it's like the silicone. It's not the brush that I've seen on YouTube, but it works. So yeah, so now I'm gonna go in and just do my eyelashes. I have a lot of fun doing my eyelashes. Like normally, if I wanna just do a really quick, simple makeup look, I'll just put on my eyeshadow and a cute little lippy and be out the door. Sorry, my eye is getting a little dry. And I found that with the mascara, the key, you honestly, even if you have a bad mascara, you can always make it work by layering. Layering is something that's really awesome. So I look down. This particular mascara is really wet, and so I look down to try to make sure I don't mess up my my eyeshadow that I just did. And my lashes seem to do really good at holding a curl. So I always just make sure that when I'm applying my mascara, and then I'm curving it up, and I like to do the edges of the mascara, because that really makes it look like you gotten your lashes done or something. Alright, so I'm gonna let that sit for a bit. You hear my cat in the background. He's in the other name and in the other room. His name's Rocky. Actually, hold on for a second. I'm gonna go let him outside so he can get some fresh air. Alright, so that's one eye, and I'm going to do a second coat, and then I'm going to come back and do this eyebrow. Give me just 1 second. Okay, so I'm back. So I just let my cat outside. Cat's outside relaxing. So I'm gonna go ahead and go in with the second coat of mascara over here. And normally when I go in with the second coat, you see how I'm just lightly tapping the edges of my lashes? I mainly just tap the edges to build up the drama. I like dramatic lashes to look somewhat natural. And the key is to just, when you build up your mascara, tap the edges. And every so often it'll clump up. And so then you gotta go in with the brush and separate. There you go. I like to try to get some on the inner lash. Depends on how I feel for the day. Sometimes I'll do it, sometimes I won't. Oh, they're clumping a lot right now. I don't like that so much. Alright, so yeah. That's good enough for me. Once I get this middle one unclumped. Yeah. So yeah, that's this eyelash look. And it looks like I got a little bit at the top. And so what I'll do is I'll go in with a Q-tip. Let's see if I can find my Q-tip. Go with the Q-tip. I'll wet it. And then I'll just go and just take that little mark right off. And then that's that. And then I'll go on with my little blending. Actually, I'll go on with the same brush. I'll tap over it because there's still some excess on there. And then I'll go on with the blender and just slightly blend it. Okay. And so that's one eyelash. And I'm going to do the other one off camera. And then I'll be back and show you how I finish my look. Okay, so I just finished my other eyelashes, and so the look is almost complete. I didn't mention anything about my eyebrows. So to be honest with you, I really don't do my eyebrows. I think they look fine. Normally this is what I'll do if I'm trying to groom them. I'll brush them up and over. Same thing with this one. Brush it up and over. But you know, honestly, most days I don't even do that. So that's how I do my eyebrows. I don't put anything else in it. I do have like this cut in my eyebrow, but I kind of like it. It's like a little space there, and it's, it lets me feel like me. So, all right, so that's that. What else do I need to do? Oh, I didn't put on blush, I realized. So, I'm going to use the same blush that I used as my eyeshadow, and I'm going to put it on my cheeks. So, yeah. I usually smile when I put on my blush and I bring it up the side of my face. A lot of times I'll kind of shape my face with the blush too, just because I feel like it adds some type of warmth. I'll put some down here too. You know, I don't really know what I'm doing. I'm not a makeup professional, but this is what I found to kind of make things look natural for me. And then just bring it up. Asha. Okay. Oh, and sorry I keep saying Asha. That means okay in Romanian. I speak Romanian, by the way. Okay. So, yeah. So, that's that. And then, normally what I'll do is a lip color. I don't know what kind of lip I want to do today. I think I'm going to do my most comfortable lip, which is kind of like a vampy red. Vampy red. Yeah. Okay. So, I'm going to go ahead and... Is there anything else I need to... Oh, highlight. Okay, I didn't highlight my face. So, and as you notice, I use the exact same brush for everything. So, for my highlight for my face, I use an eyeshadow for my highlight, which is crazy. It's this golden eyeshadow that I really, really like. And what I'll do is with this same brush, I'll bring this part up to kind of make it stiff or whatever. And then I'll just go in on the side of it. And I just get this much. And I'll just smile. And I'll add it right at the top of my cheek. I'll do the same on the other side. Right at the top of my cheek. And then go down my nose with it. Put some on my chin. Put some in this forehead area. These are places where... Well, I guess I can't say that. Normally do like a highlight if I was doing a highlight and contour, but these are the places where the sun hits, and so I like to make sure they're lit. All right, so and now you can see like I kind of look like I'm glowing a little bit. let's see if I can turn the camera a little bit. Kind of like I'm glowing a little bit, right? See it on the cheek or whatever, the high cheek. Okay. I think that's all I'll do to my face, and then I'll go ahead and put on my lips. So I have this, you guys aren't going to know this brand, but it's a Classics lip brand. It's pretty much like a, I guess like a burgundy color. So this is how that color looks. And then I'll show you the lipstick that I'm going to put on. This is a Golden Rose lipstick. And I'll swatch it for you guys. They're very similar in color. And these two paired together just look absolutely gorgeous on me. So I'm going to go ahead and line my lips, put on lipstick, and call it a day. I've already put on Vaseline. This is a matte lipstick, so it's really good to have the Vaseline on underneath it. So I'll just line my lips. If I feel like I've overdrawn my lips, I'll just go on my finger and take it off. And I always like to go down the middle to kind of give my little Cupid's bow some action. Okay, and then, okay, so then I'll go on my lipstick. And the thing I like about this lipstick too is like I can't overdo it, which is nice. So I'll do one swipe at the bottom, pat, and then I'll line. I probably like the natural line of my lip. And just, I do just kind of like blend it all out. I check to see how the lining looks. I really like my Cupid's bow to be pronounced, so I always do that. And then something else I learned off YouTube is to make sure I don't get any lipstick on my lips, I'll go in with my finger. And actually nothing came out, so I did a pretty good job. And yeah, I think this is my finished makeup look. So this is my everyday makeup look, and I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I'm very new to makeup. It's something that I just enjoy doing in my free time. It's kind of fun to see like the artistic ability that you can have to kind of make your face look, you know, glammed up or natural or whatever people like to do with their makeup. It's fun, and I hope I can do more videos like this. So what I'm going to do is actually I'm going to go ahead and finish getting ready for the day, and so you guys can see my ultimately finished look. Be back. Actually, I thought it might be kind of fun to do my ultimate look. My finished look on camera. So first thing I'm gonna do is take off my scarf. These are crochet braids that I said I've been promising forever to do a video on. I actually just took the braids down and realized that they don't look that bad. So I'm gonna keep them up for like an extra day. So I'm gonna part the hair here and take the hair down. Yeah, I kind of like how this is looking, so I'm going to do that, and I want to put on a cute little scarf. And I have earrings already ready to go. My earrings go. Here, my earrings are here. And so yeah, this is my finished look for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video, and yeah, stay tuned for more to come. I'm gonna go into the bathroom and give you guys some more action, but this is all natural lighting, and this is how I look all dialed up. So yeah, I'm gonna go into the bathroom because I like how I can get like shots of everything in here. And so yeah, so this is how I look, fully face, full face of makeup. Feeling nice, feeling bright. The hair looks okay. Yeah, so I don't know. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope to make more soon. Okay, have a wonderful, awesome, spectacular day. Bye.